Jumping right into this tutorial today, mixing equal parts of art resin. I stir it slowly for 5 minutes before pouring it into these cups. First colour is Turquoise Luster by Just Resin, Dewar Aqua Blue by Pearlex Powder Pigments, and Titanium White by Just Resin. After letting the cup sit for about 15 minutes to thicken, I start pouring it onto the artboard. I won't be using any metal powders or alcohol inks today, so good thing is I don't need to wear a mask. That's the beauty of art resin. It's safe, so I don't have to wear a mask if I use it correctly. This video is part one of a resin wave tutorial. My name's Michelle Tracy. I immediately start laying down the first wave, and I love these little silicone cups for the white. I have one and I use it for the white only because it's really good at pouring a straight line out of it. I left the first layer about 6 hours to dry before pouring the second coat. It was starting to harden, it was firming up, but it was still kind of soft and it had a tack to it. So that meant I didn't need to sand it back. The second coat would then stick to that surface much easier than it would have if I had to let it dry completely and pouring it onto a smooth finish. The colours in these close-up shots are so much more true to life. That's really how they look in person rather than their overhead shot. I'm going to have to do something about the overhead setting. That's using my phone and I'm going to have to change that because I just can't capture the right colours on my phone, unfortunately. I made the mistake of rushing into this second layer. I should have left it another few hours or really the next day and then sanded it back. The reason I rushed into it is because I'm losing my light quicker in the afternoons. Now we're heading into winter and I wanted to film this in one day and I should have left it because I can see that the second layer is sort of, it's not really sitting on top giving a real 3D look. It must be absorbing into that bottom layer, and hence the reason there is a part two. I'm going to correct this and you'll see what I do. Stay tuned. Welcome back to part two of this ocean resin wave tutorial. My name's Michelle Tracy. Now that I've stirred my resin for 5 minutes, it's time to add my pigment. I'm just using the one color, Turquoise Luster from Just Resin, and the brand of resin I've mixed it into is Art Resin. My phone makes it look blue, but it's actually turquoise. And all those tiny little bubbles will rise to the top once I leave it to sit for 15 minutes in the cup. Those scratch marks are just from where I sanded it back. I did that so that the resin had something to stick to rather than a slick surface. You may recall in the last video, I wasn't happy with how that wave turned out. It was a bit too runny and it wasn't getting that three-dimensional look. So the plan is to go over it again after letting it dry fully for 24 hours, so it was hard this time, so now the paint will sit on the surface. And as I thought may happen, the resin has ran down lower than that line, even though I've tilted the board forward so that wouldn't happen. It has, so now you can actually see that wave underneath. So I'm adding more white to try and fill that in and see if that helps. On the positive note, I'm getting that nice three-dimensional look I wanted in the first place. I've got a beautiful soft line that's happening. It's a rounded edge. It looks so good. I just wish it hadn't have dropped down. And if I was to tilt my board any further forward, the whole resin just would have run off. So this is how it looks. I'm not happy with it. So you can see that line. So plan B, or should I say plan C? Crystals. Yeah, so this video's really turned out to be a good lesson in what not to do. And you always have options. Don't give up. And actually, I prefer it with the crystals. As soon as I started placing them on, I went, yep, this is me. Now, this looks like my art. As always, I'd love to hear from you, and I'd love to know if anyone else has been down a similar path to this before. Have you had the same problems I've had in this? Thank you.